Good evening, everybody. A woman is a full circle. Within her is the power to create, nurture, and transform. It is my honor to introduce our guest speaker of the day, Honorable Mrs. Lata Pandirajan, ma'am, Iron Lady of Maffei Group of Companies. She is one of our India's greatest business icon who has revolutionized HR, accounting, and admin policy in the country. As the co-founder of Maffei, India is the first and biggest HR service firm. She is personally responsible for generating career opportunity for almost half a million Indian youngsters in the companies across the globe. From humble beginning, she has grown the Maffei Group of Company into the global business that it is today. With the hard work, zeal, unending dedication, and the ability to face any adversity with a smile. She is a guiding light for young entrepreneurs in the country and has consulted and incubated several companies. She is a great mentor. She is a great human being. She has involved several socio-economic development and activities. She is a managing director of Varnam Capital, a microfinance company that specializes cater to needs of underprivileged women. As a part of Maffei Foundation, she has institute schemes such as Disha and Sornam that empowers women and children across Tamil Nadu. She is the founder trustee of Sornamal Educational Trust that provides assistance and vocational training to almost 65,000 women across Tamil Nadu. She is an active Rotarian and regular participant in the other charitable organizations like the Handicapped Federation and Agram Foundation. She is also a trustee of Tamil Nadu Kidney Research Foundation, which provides healthcare for the underprivileged. So as much as I would like to list her several achievements, I do not want to keep our participant wait any longer from listening ma'am's speech. So without further ado, ma'am, I invite you to start the session. The floor is yours, ma'am.
Thank you, Elil. Thank you so much. Thanks to Axis Global Automation for all the good work you're doing, especially in the area of automation, which is going to be the face of the next century as such. And I'm very happy. And as I was talking, I'm very happy to be with all of you students, especially today, and the others who are here today joining, share my own views and experiences. And that way, as Elil said, I've also experienced him to be a very down-to-earth, very genuine person. I think a grassroots level entrepreneur. So in that sense, I think it's nice to see grassroots level entrepreneurs struggle and grow in that sense. So I think that's what Elil has done. And so I'm very, very happy to be here to share my own experiences. And and especially like Elil told me, I can talk about the kind of challenges, obstacles that are there and how do we convert that into opportunities, especially in these times that way. So I think it's a wonderful topic because also I know that especially in the last 3 months, there have been a lot of changes in everyone's life that way. Okay, everybody around the world, not a single person is spared in this that way. You know, suddenly like new words, new terminologies have emerged. Words like lockdown, work from home, study from home, pandemic, virus, all which is like a science fiction movie to many of us that way. We've seen most of this only in films, and at least I never thought in my lifetime I will really see something, you know, about like a virus and a pandemic and things like that. But it has happened, so that's reality that way. Okay, so people are talking about many new things, and everybody talks about this word called new normal. Okay, everybody says whatever it is after this pandemic, it is not going to be normal. Okay, it will be normal, but it will be a new normal. Okay, so I think like it's important for us to understand what is this new normal and what are the expectations in this new normal now. Okay, so I thought like, you know, that would be the most important thing that we need to really understand at this point in time that way. Okay, so I just thought I'll share my views, especially about generally first, how do we really convert challenges into opportunities? And then come to specifics in terms of today, what is the scenario? if whether COVID or other than COVID also, especially the industry, what does it expect? Okay, how is it going to be the future of work and things like that? I will share my views on that also that way. So I have just a kind of a few slides. Let me just open it up. Yeah, it's visible?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am, it's visible.
It's visible, yeah. Okay, so let's start with, as I said, it is like, the thing is to convert obstacles into opportunities. Okay, to convert obstacles into opportunities. First, I said, I'm going to speak generally what needs to be done, okay? It is important for us to understand what is this obstacle. Okay, especially as students, what kind of challenges we are facing in our lives that way. Okay, people talk about SWOT analysis. In any organization, we do something called a SWOT analysis. Okay, strength, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. Okay, that's what is called a SWOT analysis. Okay, SWOT they say. And it's very important, even as individuals, we really understand what is at least our strengths and weaknesses. Okay, so many a times I tell students it is important that you sit and you write down what are these challenges, what are these obstacles which you have. Okay, so weaknesses basically. Okay, and so it can be simple things like some people may not have attention to details. Okay, generally overall they will do very well, but something in detail they may not be able to understand what it is that way. Okay, so it's important for you. Some people cannot say no to anyone. Okay, anybody, anything they say, they will say yes. Okay, so I mean, like, it is good at times, but at times it is also not so good that way. You need to know when to say no to certain things in life that way. Okay, so that's something, that's a weakness. You need to really write down as to what is that weakness, which, because unless you understand the weakness, you will not be able to understand how do you overcome that weakness. Okay, so it's good for you to just take a paper and pen and write down clearly. Like some people can't ask for help. Okay, everything they will want to do themselves. At times it is good, but at times it is not so good. Okay, you will need to know how to ask for help. Okay, not that in the world, all of us can do everything ourselves. Okay, so it is very, very important that you write down one by one, whatever it is. Some people will not have certain kind of a confidence. Okay, so write down, or something to do with writing, speaking, whatever is your weakness. I think it is important to write down our weakness. Okay, you cannot manage your future if you do not understand what your future is about. Okay, same way you cannot manage your weakness if you do not understand. So many a times what happens is we get very conditioned. Okay, because we are brought up in a certain way. Okay, it is like, I'm sure you must have seen this many a times. You would have seen a huge elephant being tied to a iron rod, iron chain as such in many of the places. If you go to a temple and all that. Okay, have you ever wondered, like that one small chain is tying that elephant. Do you think that elephant can't come out taking off that chain? It can come out, but it won't come out. You know why? Because right from when it is small, they have tied that elephant to one big iron chain that way. When it is small, that iron chain is big, so it cannot come out easily. So it will keep pulling and pulling and pulling and seeing that way. Okay, after some time, since it can't come out, it will give up and it will start remaining that way. And as it keeps growing up, the same chain that you get tied to, but it will never even attempt to come out. Okay, so what has happened is it has got conditioned like that. They even did an experimentation once. You know what they did? They took one huge shark and they put it into a tank with small fishes. The moment the shark was put into the pink tank, it ate up all the small fishes that way. Okay, after three, four days, they put one huge obstacle in between. Okay, a kind of a glass shutter. Okay, so the moment the glass shutter was there, the shark used to go hit against that shutter. and you to see all the small fishes swimming the other side. Okay, you keep on hitting, and it, since it cannot go, it will turn back that way. Okay, so this happened for 1 week. After that, what they did, they removed the glass shutter and they again let the shark swim in that water. And it was swimming, the small fishes were also there, and it did nothing to the small fishes because it has got conditioned that way, that it cannot eat. Same thing in life, I think many a times we get conditioned that this is what I can do, this is what I cannot do. Okay, I don't have this competency, I can't do this, I can't say this, I can't. I think our conditioning, we need to really remove those shackles. It is very important that we come out of those conditioning that way. Okay, so you need to figure out what are all your weaknesses and see one by one, how do I overcome them? Okay, every time you need to review and see a lot. And how do you convert that into positive? How do you convert that weakness into an opportunity for you that way? It was very important that we really work towards it, and it's possible. There are so many examples of how people have converted their weakness into opportunity. I'll give you a story that way. This supposed to have happened in Japan, and since it's automation and things like that, Japanese stories I think are very relevant here that way. Okay, so I think this happened in Japan. This little boy, he was a judo champion that way, and he was really winning all competitions, and in one accident he lost his left hand. Okay, so he was without his left hand, so he was feeling very sad. So there was one judo master, a big sage, who came and he said, don't worry, I will train you. Okay, you listen to me, I will train you for 3 months, then you can take part in the competitions once again. So this judo master trains him for 3 months. And this boy also, a very, very hardworking boy, so he trains himself for 3 months, whatever the master says, he listens. And after 3 months, and he teaches him one particular step completely thoroughly that way. So he learns that, and then the master says, now you can go and you can go for your tournaments also. Okay, go and join in tournaments. So he's a little perplexed. So fast my master is telling me to join in the tournaments, but he listens to the master, he goes to the tournament. The first tournament is happening, he wins the tournament. Second tournament is happening, he wins the tournament. The third one, the final one, and that is with one person who is much larger than him, bigger than him, a real champion he is, and he's very scared. In fact, the referee himself is very scared because he doesn't have a hand. How will he really play this tournament and all that? And but the master says, no, you just let him, he will do it. And the tournament starts and he starts playing, and what happens is the opponent makes a small mistake. And for a second, he makes a mistake and this guy hits him back, and he wins. Okay, then he wonders, what is this? And then everybody asks him, what happened? And he says, I really don't know. You ask my master. My master is the one who trained me that way. So everybody runs to the master and asks him, how does this happen? He doesn't even have a left hand. So he says, only two things I did. One, I taught him a move, and I made him master that move. Okay, so he's a master of that move as such, that way. And two, I taught him one move, so that because the opponent, when he hits him, he has to catch hold of his left hand. And since he does not have his left hand, he suddenly gets perplexed for a second and he can hit him with that move which I taught him. Okay, he said, all I did was to convert his weakness into an opportunity. Okay, all of us, like that boy, probably do not have some left hand or whatever it is. Okay, some weakness we do not have. Okay, so it is important first to understand. That is why I said you write down first, what is it we don't have, and then work towards it as to how people can help us. So very, very important first thing is to understand your obstacles, challenges. Okay, the next one, let me come to controlling our attitude. Okay, I think more than anything in life, I think it is attitude which can define our life. Okay, I think at any point in time, we need to live with a positive attitude. Okay, I think you take examples of big leaders or anybody who's really done well in life. Okay, people say it is that confidence, it is that will. Okay, you read anybody, you read about Mahatma Gandhi, for instance. You know, Mahatma Gandhi was thrown out of the train in South Africa. And very nicely, he writes in his autobiography, it is that moment. Okay, because normally when something like that happens, we feel very low. He says, I did not feel low. I felt that spirit. Okay, I felt that I need to do something about this. Okay, so attitude, you take any players, you take Sachin Tendulkar, you take actors, okay, you read about them. Everybody will say, it is that positive attitude which gave me that strength. Okay, so I think it is very, very important, especially as students. Okay, it's very, very important that we understand that attitude makes a lot of difference. Okay, whatever you're doing, you're studying, you're not, whatever you're doing, I think first thing you need to feel is, they always say, where there is a will, there is a way. Okay, so there's always a way for anything that way. Okay, so that attitude, and more importantly, times like this, when you're sitting at home and studying and things like that, it is very, very important you have positive attitude, because there's so much of negativity around us that way. Okay, very recently you must have seen a Bollywood actor committing suicide. Okay, I mean, these things happen because we do not have a positive attitude. It is not success, it is not money. Okay, they are important, I'm not saying no, but they are not the whole thing. They're not the end all in life that way. Okay, there's much more to life. And to understand that, you need to have a very, very positive attitude. Okay, whatever, come what may, there's always a solution in life. Okay, you must have heard of Steve Jobs. You know something about Steve Jobs? Steve Jobs was thrown out of Apple at one time, that way. Okay, and then he started in his one more small company. Okay, and that company was again taken over by Apple, and then he became a CEO after that, and he literally changed the way the Apple was working. Okay, so I think there are hundreds of examples where people, because of that attitude, not feeling low, okay, feel very positive, whatever you're doing, okay, and you will find a way. If you have the attitude, you will always find a way, okay. And so that's attitude, very, very important. I always say, more than anything, attitude is the most important. You get up in the morning, you need to feel good about yourself. You need to feel that you can do something that way, okay? So I think that attitude is what will really help us succeed in life. So let's come to the third one. Hope is not a plan, set goals, okay? So many times we say, I hope this happens. I'm hoping that this will go through. I'm hoping. Hope is not a plan. Okay, you can hope, but you need to plan for your life. Okay, planning is very, very different. If you don't plan for your life, you cannot overcome obstacles. Okay, so you need to be clear. At least whatever people say, you need to set goals for yourself, right? People talk about, when I talk about setting goals, not only professional goals, even personal goals. Okay, and very clearly you need to set goals. Talking about goals, people normally say you need to set SMART goals. Okay, this word SMART is very important in front of a goal, because every goal, when I say SMART, there S stands for specific, M stands for measurable, A stands for achievable, R stands for relevant, and T stands for time bound. Okay, you can't just set goals saying that I will read a book. That's not a goal. Okay, you need to say, I will read a book within a month. I will read this kind of a book within 2 months. I will learn something new, learn a new skill within 6 months. Okay, every goal has to be, that's what they say, SMART. It has to be specific and it has to be measurable. If you can't measure a goal, then it's not interesting that way. Generic things, actually have no meaning. Okay, so that's why it's measurable, and it has to be also time bound. Okay, within 6 months, within 1 year, within 3 years, I finish my college, and then within 3 years, I should become this. Or within 10 years, I should get into a senior management position. Okay, that's the kind of goals you need to set. Okay, so never forget SMART goals. No point in just setting goals. It doesn't happen. Okay, so write down SMART goals. Even today, I write down my 6 monthly goals. Okay, what do I need to do in 6 months? And I keep reviewing. It happens. Certain things may happen. Certain things may not happen. Then I say, I take 3 more months or 6 more months, whatever it may be. Okay, like in this COVID period, I decided I will learn a new language that way. And I'm learning online. French, I'm learning. Okay, so next 6 months, I've decided something I will really achieve by then. So I think you need to set a goal and then keep working. Okay, I think as students, it is very, very important. Otherwise, we will lose sight of the larger picture that way. Okay, we will just be floating around in our day-to-day activities, and we will not be able to achieve larger things. Okay, I think you need to have a vision for yourself and set goals. Okay, so whatever, it may change, that doesn't matter. It happens even in organizations. Okay, there's a vision we have, we set goals, but we keep changing goals. Okay, so I think it is important that you learn to have a vision and set goals. Vision is nothing but a little ahead you see for yourself that way. Okay, what you want to be that way. Okay, so if you're a specific engineer, say like, I will finish and I will do this that way. Okay, so whatever it may be, have a vision for yourself and set SMART goals and not just goals. So very important in life to set SMART goals. Okay. And now let me come to another important thing. If you have to overcome obstacles in life, okay, that's passion and focus. Okay. So passion is that burning desire to do something. Okay. People normally say, like, I'm sure like you would have read, if you have read Dr. Abdul Kalam's books, Dr. Abdul Kalam says that your dream should be a dream that it will not allow you to sleep. Okay, normally people get dreams in their sleep, but your dream should be such that it doesn't allow you to sleep. Okay, that's the passion. Okay, you can see the passion that man had. Even till the last minute, he was addressing students. Okay, that's the passion he had for students as such. Okay, so for anything in life, you need to have a certain passion. Okay, that I can do this. And once you have that passion, then it will never be seen as a burden. Okay, it will never seem like as a work. It will be part of your life. Okay, so you will know like, okay, like this is fun. And whatever it may be. Okay, and it can be reading something, it can be talking about any kind of material or whatever it is that way. Okay, that passion in life actually drives us. Every day it drives us till the end of our life. Okay, you can see even people who are in their, you must have seen, I'm sure like some of you would have seen this company called KFC. Okay, KFC, this famous US chain. Okay. And that man, Colonel Sanders, started KFC in his 60s. And he was 64, he started KFC and made it so big that way. Why go to US? Come to our land, okay, in Tamil Nadu. Okay, you must have heard of this company called Arvind Eye Hospital. Okay, he's called, the person who started it is called Mr. V. Okay, Venkateswamy, he also started Arvind in his 60s. After retirement, he started. Okay, so he decided that I want to make a change in people's lives. And he decided to start Arvind Eye Hospital, saying that poor people can also have access to good healthcare. Okay, that was his vision. Okay, see the passion even in 60s. Okay, so in your 20s and 30s, I'm sure you should have great passion to do certain things. Okay, today you're living in a world filled with technology that way. So you can really discover something. Okay, you can patent something So many opportunities you have, but you can do that only if you have a passion. Okay, next comes focus. Absolute focus. Because many a times what happens, especially in our 20s, I've also gone through the 20s, so I know that way. Okay, there are so many things in our life. Okay, and we lose focus as to where should we really pay attention. Okay, so it's important. It should be absolute the target. Like you must have heard of the story of Dronacharya, right? Dronacharya used to really help both the Pandavas and the Kauravas. Okay, he used to train both of them. But always Arjuna was his favorite, and people used to feel bad about it. Why is only Arjuna the favorite? So one day, what does he do? He calls everyone and he puts one wooden bird on a tree, and he looks at Yudhishthira and asks him, what do you see? And Yudhishthira says, I see a tree, I see the branches, it's green, leaves, the fruits, and I see the bird and the eye. And he asks everyone the same thing they say. They say, everyone is seeing the tree, everyone is seeing the branches. He calls Arjuna and asks him, what do you see? Arjuna clearly says, I only see the eye of the bird. Okay, that's the focus. Okay, that's the target. You can have many things in your life, but there has to be certain focus into what you want to achieve in life. Okay, so I think please don't leave the focus. Very, very critical that passion and focus are two things that will keep driving you, that will keep allowing you to enjoy your path. Okay, it's not enough that you just have a path. Okay, success is not just the end result. Okay, success is basically like, even if you have a loss, like understanding the loss and enjoying the path so that you achieve something. Okay, like Edison, Thomas Alva Edison, when he discovered bulb, he said, that must be the 1,000th time when I discovered the bulb. But I managed it 999 times without discovering, but I continued. Okay, so it is important. If you have a passion, you'll keep continuing. Okay, so many people in this world have done that. Okay, especially if you really see large companies, how they were built because of the passion. You see a Reliance, if Mr. Dhirubhai Ambani did not have the passion, okay, he was actually, what was he doing in Yemen? He was actually in a petrol pump working. Okay, so he came back to India and set up the refinery, petroleum refinery. He said when he was in Yemen, he decided one day I'll go back to my country and set up a refinery. And that passion drove him back to this country. And today, even today, Reliance is in the newspaper. Okay, they've become debt-free. Read about it. It's very interesting that way to understand what is debt-free, that large company does not have debt today. Okay, so that's the passion. That's the focus. So keep moving ahead and challenge the obstacle. Okay, as I've written here, obstacles do not block our path. They are our path. Many times we don't understand. Okay, that is the path that way. Okay, so we think, oh God, it's a problem, it's an obstacle. So that is the path you're shown. So you need to cross that and understand. Okay, once Socrates, in fact, I have this very nicely written because this is something very close to my heart. It's not even a story, it happened really. Okay, when a small little boy came and asked Socrates, what is success? What does Socrates do? He takes the little boy to a river nearby and actually ducks him in the water. Okay, puts his head in the water very hard for a long time so that he can't breathe that way. So he's struggling in the water and he pulls him out then. Then he asks him, what do you want now? He says, I want air. So he says, when you want success as badly as you want the air, then you will get it. Okay, there is no other secret to success. Okay, same way, if we want something, we need to want it badly. Okay, if you need to want it badly, if you want it badly, you will get it. So if you want to pass well with good marks, you will get it if you have that passion. If you want to get a good job, if you have the passion and work towards it, you will get it. Okay, if you want to start your own company, if you have the passion and hard work, you will get it. Okay, so that's what this Socrates says out there very beautifully. I think success is possible. Okay, success actually is a byproduct that way. Okay, if you work hard, if you have a good idea, if you are honest to yourself that way, and if you have the passion and the focus, success will follow, like happiness. Okay, happiness and success are byproducts that way. Okay, it will come, okay, if you work towards it. So that's generally as to how you really manage obstacles. Okay, so now let me come to where we are now as such. Okay, what is it we need to do? What kind of challenges we are facing now? Okay, as students, as others, whatever. Okay, and what do we do to really manage those challenges that way? Okay, of course, as you said, Socrates' secret of success still stays. Okay, that's the secret in that sense. Okay, but let's look at the kind of challenges we are entering into. Okay, so first and foremost, let me talk about the COVID challenge. Okay, all of us, I think for the last almost 3 months, as I said, we are talking about COVID and COVID. A word which was not there in our dictionary for the last, I mean, before 3-4 months, honestly. Okay, we never even heard about it and things like that. Okay, maybe December, we started hearing in China, things are happening, Wuhan, COVID and all that. It almost looked like, you know, we are very safe. Something is happening in China. Okay, okay, let it happen, kind of a thing. Okay, and then January, little by little, started moving. People started saying, it's moved to Europe. Okay, it's moved to US and all that. Even then, I think, like, you know, there was this thing, people started saying, India is a very hot country, it will not come here and all that. Okay, but in March, we know when our Prime Minister came out into the national television and said, India is locking down for 3 weeks. I think, like, completely things changed. Okay, can you imagine a country with 1.3 billion population locking down? Something huge that way. Okay, but it happened. Okay, and from then on, all of us know life is quite changed quite a bit. Okay, so many of us are, you know, at home now, of course, with technology, online, Zoom, Microsoft Teams. I mean, this has become a way of life now that way. Okay, so that's the kind of challenge. There's so much of negativity also around us. Okay, so so many cases and so many people dying and all that. So I think in these challenging times, first, it is important that we take care of two things. Okay, we take care of our physical health, we take care of our mental health. Okay, both are extremely critical at this point in time. Our physical health, because of course we know it is an unknown enemy. Okay, so we really don't know, there's no medicine to it, there's no vaccine to it and things like that. So whatever we think, and there are different people saying this is good, this is bad. Okay, most of it are assumptions in that sense as of now. Okay, so I think whatever is good for us, but in a way, physical, little bit, whatever little physical activity, because I think now that colleges are closed and all that, there's absolutely no physical activity for many of us. Okay, it is important that you do at least something. Okay, it can be sitting at home and doing some yoga or some breathing exercises, whatever, because I personally feel if you do not have the physical health at this point in time, and if you do not take care of it, we are careless at this point in time, it will hit us somewhere later on. Okay, so it is important that we learn to physically take care of ourselves in whatever little way. Mental health. Okay, I think very new experience. I was talking about this new normal. Okay, so sitting at home, people are not allowed to go outside much that way. Okay, everything happens over the net, over the system. You're always attached to gadgets now. Okay, it's mobile or laptop, mobile or laptop. Okay, all these things, whether we like it or not, because we are not designed like that as human beings. Okay, it puts a certain stress on us physically and mentally. Okay, so we need to recognize that. Okay, and we need to recognize and keep ourselves mentally fit also by reading good things. Okay, maybe reading a book, reading good articles, because today there's so many things happening around us, so much of information. Okay, so it's important that you read the right information and good information that way. Okay, so that's a very important challenge all of us are facing right now. Okay, so see to it that you utilize it well. Okay, this COVID challenge, be very sensitive to everything that's happening around us, understand what is happening around us. I think it is very, very critical that we have that spirit, we have that positive spirit every day, that we keep going. Okay, so that's a huge challenge we need to overcome, because we don't know how long it's going to be, when are the colleges going to open. There is also an uncertainty we are dealing with in life. Okay, at this point in time, that way. Okay, so I think it is important we are conscious of it. Okay, I'm sure, like, as youngsters, you'll be able to handle it. Okay, so definitely you'll be able to handle it. But still, I think it's important that you understand and appreciate it and do the relevant things at this point in time. Okay, so very, very important that you do relevant things. Now let's come to job-related challenges. Okay. So what are the kind of challenges? Are there going to be changes that way? Okay, I think COVID as such, definitely in my view, will have different changes in different industries. A couple of days or 3 days back, I was reading in a newspaper saying that you must have heard of this company called Kevin Care, right? One of the largest companies in the south of Tamil, the entire India, was started by this gentleman called Mr. Ranganathan, C.K. Ranganathan, that way. He's the CEO of Kevin Care. So they have a beautiful corporate office in Chennai. Okay, in Cenotaph Road in Chennai, heart of the city, they have a beautiful corporate office, which is 40,000 square feet. Okay, and Mr. C.K.R. came out in the paper and said, it's their own corporate office. He said, from now on, our people are going to work from home. We are not going to have come to office. And the 40,000 square feet, if anyone wants it on rent, please take it. He's put up a notice. Okay. These are the kind of changes. It is a huge change. Till now, we've only heard of IT industry sitting and working at home. Okay. We've never heard of FMCG sitting and working at home. It is a FMCG industry, fast moving consumer goods. You have this Fair Hour and Nile and many of these chick shampoo and all these products. Okay. So, I mean, things are going to be disrupted in the industry. Okay. We all know there are certain industries, even during the last 3 months, were open. Okay. Like healthcare, pharma industry, IT, IT-enabled services. Okay. And online education. These are some of the industries which were running even during COVID. Okay. Some of the industries completely shut. Travel, tourism, aviation, all this completely not happening. Okay. Some of the industries in the short time, I think they were closed and now slowly getting back that way. Manufacturing, some of the factories have started that way. Logistics is happening. Okay. So some of these things have slowly started getting back. Okay. So one, you need to understand at this point in time, what kind of jobs will be available? Okay. For that, you need to understand what kind of industries in the next 5 years will move well, will grow well. Okay. What kind of challenges the industry will be facing? Okay. So as I said, some of these industries definitely will have a faster growth. Okay. Because the government will pump in money into healthcare because it's very important. Now, COVID has also told us very clearly that a good healthcare infrastructure in the country is very critical. That way, hospitals, having good other pharmacies and things like that. Okay. So healthcare is one industry. Pharmacy is another industry. Agriculture. One good thing is during these last 3-4 months, thankfully in India, we got our food. Okay. We got vegetables, we got rice, we got wheat. Okay. So I think, but India having 1.3 billion population also needs food for this 1.3 billion population. Okay. So I think agriculture is one area. Definitely. So I mean, there will be a certain focus. And today agriculture is getting automated. Okay. A lot of changes in agriculture is happening. People are talking about, predicting whatever is going to happen, weather changes and things like that. Okay, agri analytics is another area which is really taken off very well. I'm sure during the COVID times, you would have seen every channel every day saying that so many deaths. So everybody, what are they doing? They're using artificial intelligence at the back and doing data analytics. Okay, so it's very, very important we understand what kind of job-related challenges will be there and what is it industry will be looking for, okay, in terms of the candidate. Okay, so that's also an important thing when it comes to job-related challenges. Okay, so, one is, of course, which industry and things like that. And two is, of course, what kind of competencies. Okay, so today with these kind of changes, everybody will want candidates who are flexible and adaptable. Okay, they will want students because with these kind of unpredictability that's happening. Okay, so you need to learn to be very agile. So agility is an important competency which people will be looking for now. Okay, we have been in the recruitment industry for 3 decades and I have seen the kind of changes that have happened in the workplace and workforce in the last 3 decades. Okay, so some of these things are very new. When clients come and tell us, so for this job role, this is the competency. Most of the job roles, they're saying like these are some of the competencies they should have. One is creativity. Okay, so you need to have creative and critical thinking. Okay, so you need to really think differently. Think out of the box that way. It's not necessary that earlier days, people never used to bother much about this critical thinking and all that. So, but today, I think most of the clients who come to us very clearly say, students need to have this creative and critical thinking, flexibility, adaptability, agility that way. There's another competence they talk about is resilience. Okay, resilience is nothing but if there is a problem, how will they handle it? How will they respond to it that way? Okay, so I think, of course, technology is a given today. Okay, like we say earlier, it was academics and skills. Okay, these are the two things people always used to tell us. Okay, if you give 50% weightage to academics, you give 50% weightage to skills. Okay, so wherever I used to go and speak also, I used to always say, how much ever importance to whatever marks you're getting, you should also get your skills. Okay, today it is academics, skills, technology, all three. Okay, without this, you don't get a job. It's as simple as that. Okay, because technology has become part and parcel of every job role. Okay, so I think it is important that we understand like how much of weightage to academics, how much of weightage to skills, and how much of weightage to technology. So that depends on a role. Okay, what job roles are there? Today, job roles are getting completely redefined. Okay, so many, many things, as I said, are changing. So it's very important that you need to understand what the changes that are happening in the job roles. You also need to understand what changes are happening in the industries. Okay, so which industries will do well, which industries will take a longer time, which industries will actually have changes on a continuous basis. Okay, so I think look at everything that is happening around you. That way, there are new industries today. I think in the last a decade or so, I have seen so many startups that have come up. Okay, and today some of the startups pay very well also in that sense, tech-related startups. So people are just, sitting at home and doing many new businesses. Okay, so many things have become a reality because of the tectonic shift in terms of technology. Okay, so please understand that you need to really see as to what are the industries which are doing well. I was jokingly saying the other day that to any industry you add one tech there, that part of it will keep doing well. Okay, whether it's agriculture, you put tech there, agri-tech is doing well. Or logistics, you put one tech there, logitech, it's doing well. Okay, now in healthcare, the health tech part of it is doing well. Okay, so I think technology in a sense has become part of every role now that way. Okay, so please keep in mind, industry is also important, roles also important. So constantly keep looking out what are the changes that are happening and keep adding to yourself the skills. Okay, it's a great time. Some of you are working from home or studying from home and things like that. Okay, please pick up some skills. I think there are lots of courses available online today, some of them even free. Some of the even Ivy League colleges like Harvard and Stanford and all put out online courses today. Okay, so I think it's time that we keep equipping ourselves. Okay, reskilling and upskilling are the two words which are very, very important in our lives. Okay, I think it's important that we learn to forget old things and keep learning new things. Okay, so I think reskilling, upskilling, do not forget. Keep upskilling yourself and keep reskilling. Okay, something new also, you need to keep adding to yourself. So that's relating to the job-related challenges. Let me come to the third one, automation and digitalization. I touched upon it already, saying that, you know, technology has really become a part and parcel of every role as such that way. Okay, but I think there are a lot more to it. In fact, almost all the big four, whether it's Deloitte or PwC or even McKinsey, most of them have done reports, especially when it comes to India. How is automation and digitalization affecting India or going to affect? Okay, and there are a number of reports on it. I think you can go through it, you can read it. And it talks mainly about, there was a Dell report which I read, very interesting, some time back, saying that almost 60 to 70% of the roles that are there today will not be there in 5 years. Okay, so many things will change that way. Okay, automation happening, robots coming. But there's also a nice statement I read that day, the robots are coming not to take away your jobs, but to change them. Okay, so changes are going to happen that way. Okay, but at the same time, I don't think so. We will always get new industries and new job roles that will get created that way. Okay, so it is important for us to understand what is this automation about. And sometimes you don't even know what is this job role about. So it is important. That is why I said, when I looked at competencies, you need to be flexible enough, adaptable enough to keep learning. Okay, something new comes in the market, pick it up. It's not difficult. Okay, if you're mentally agile, you'll be able to learn new things that way. Okay, so yeah, automation, definitely there have been lots of questions whether automation will take away jobs and things like that. Okay, I can see Elil smiling, okay, because he is in the space and I know they make robots. I was also talking to Elil the other day about it and things like that. And I can tell you very clearly, okay, it is not that they will take away all jobs. Okay, the job roles will become different. Okay, there have to be people around to understand, and people can move on to more knowledgeable roles. Okay, so when I talked about analytics, when I talked about, you know, putting together data, people are saying data has become the new oil. Okay, how oil became so important to us in life a couple of decades back, today I think data has become. Okay, everything is driven by data today. Okay, so it is important. It's part of our lives now in that sense. Okay, so I think we cannot ignore it. People are talking about Industry 4.0. I'm sure all of you would have heard about this. Okay, so Industry 4.0, where we will have the cyber physical systems interacting and talking to each other and things like that. Okay, so obviously productivity will increase, and it is important that we see. So it is important that we feel we need to do something to ourselves to keep ourselves relevant. Okay, and that's possible. So it is important we figure out what is it we learn, so that we learn to really live with the robots. And robots are going to come into every industry. Okay, earlier, the moment you say robots, you only think about manufacturing industry. Today, there are robots in hotels. Okay, so every industry, hospitality industry, every industry, because wherever there is continuous kind of an activity, monotonous activity, I mean, you can really think that they can do it with a robot that way. Okay, even in COVID times, in some of the countries, I mean, they're using robots. Even here, they're using robots to really, give food and give the medicines so that there's no touch from a human being. Okay, so it can be utilized well in that sense. Okay, so it's important that we really understand. We don't see it as a challenge. We need to see it as an opportunity. We need to see it as something which is going to support us in our lives. Okay, so I think if we start looking at it that way, I think life will become simple. So you reorient yourself and start working in that sense. As I said, upskilling, reskilling, the pace has to improve. You need to keep learning new things. Okay, and today it is available in small capsules. Just take that time. Okay, have that interest, because as I said, everything around us is changing. Earlier days, people are not even reading newspapers. Everything today, you people have it on your mobile. Okay, so all consumption is happening through media, through tech media today. Okay, so with that kind of automation, digitalization happening around us, it is important that you recognize what kind of changes are happening and you keep adding value to yourself. Okay, so very, very important that we can't ignore. Okay, it's there to stay. It has come already that way. So all we need to do is to see as to how do we live with it in that sense. Okay, so how do we live with it? Because that doesn't have life. We have life. Okay, so we need to see as to how do we use that to complement us. Okay, to help us out that way. It is just a support system in that sense. Okay, so let's really look at it that way, not get scared about automation. What I mean to say is that, okay, so don't get scared about automation, learn about automation and digitalization and see as to how you can utilize it yourself and see how you can learn about it. Because I think totally most of the industries now are moving to that way. Okay, and most of the jobs in that area will obviously give you more salary. Okay, so there will be good jobs. If you understand that area today, user experience designer or a data analytics person gets huge salary. Okay, because they understand the latest technology. So it is important that you learn all these things as students. I think like very, very important to understand, appreciate, go through some courses, even get that passion again, passion to learn. Okay, so I think that will really help you. Definitely will be help you, because whichever industry you touch tomorrow, they will have this as such. Some part of it getting automated and digitalized as such. Okay, so very important. Now let me come to the next challenge of the future of work. Okay, so I think if we have to put like a movie, like 10 years later, how is the workspace going to be? Okay, how is work going to be? How is workspace going to be? How is the work manpower going to be? Okay, all three are important that way. So if we have to, they say crystal gazing. Okay, so if we have to crystal gaze and see as to how it's going to be. Okay, one, I must say, as I said, many of these industries which are there will undergo changes. Okay, so I gave you an example of how Kevin Kerr said, like, we're going to work from home. Okay, so I think many industries will change the way things are really happening that way. Okay, it's not that I'm going to say like everybody is going to work from home. Okay, it's not possible. There are some roles which have to be on the field only that way. Okay, so it's not that everything is possible, but every industry will really undergo a number of changes that way. Okay, whether it's IT industry, whether it's healthcare, logistics, education, FMCG, okay, and banking, financial services. I mean, there was a time when, we used to visit the bank. Today, I mean, many, especially this generation, may not have even visited the bank. Okay, all you need to do is just take your mobile and transfer money. That's it. Okay, you do Paytm, you do Phone Pay, or you do Google Pay. Okay, so I mean, look at the way things are changing. So the bank also has to change that way. Okay, it does not have to have cashiers and all that. Earlier they used to have a role called cashier. I know some of you would not even have heard of that role. Okay, who will give money? So today it's not that you go to an ATM and take money that way. Okay, so I think every industry will undergo changes that way. Okay, so especially the millennials and the Generation Z, which is getting into work, you really need to understand what is this change in work that way. Okay, so technology, as I said, will play a very, very important role in this future of work. Okay, I think everything will be tech driven. And the way people will look at work itself will be very, very different in that sense. Okay. And people are talking about something called a gig economy, temporary, short-term relationships with the employer. Okay, 6 months to 1 year. Actually, if you see Europe, this gig economy has been there for a very long time. For example, in countries like France and all that, where gig economy is very high, almost 70% of the people in France work on a contract that way. Okay. And they're happy. Like they will work for 2 years in one place and then leave, take 3 months off and then go and work in another place. Okay. So they gain different kinds of experiences. I think slowly it's coming into our country also. And the youth, especially you as students, I think many of you don't like something very permanent. Okay, like for instance, my father, when he worked for the railways, I think he joined the railways, he retired from the railways that way. Okay, and that was seen to be the best at that time in terms of you join somewhere, you'll retire from somewhere, from the same place. Okay, so you join a company like the Tatas, you will retire from the Tatas. Today, I think it just does not happen. Most people apparently stay on maximum for 3 to 4 years. Even that itself is quite high. Okay, 2 years. Beyond that, people want to move. They want to experience different things. They want to really see, different things as such. Okay, so I think this gig economy, this temporariness, okay, it doesn't really seem to be very temporary to them. They are very happy. Okay, so this generation is happy with gig economy, with a young population. And India is supposed to have the youngest population in the world that way. Okay, our average age is less than 30 in that sense. Okay, so with that happening, see the kind of work, people will keep changing the workspace that way. And you'll comfortably do it. Okay, whereas my generation was a little bit more hesitant that way. Okay, so kind of changes that, you know, tech will really bring. And people talk about this world being very, very different. Okay, it's very ambiguous. They call it the VUCA world. Okay, VUCA world, nothing. VUCA stands for, it's volatile. Okay, U stands for uncertain. And C stands for complex. And A stands for ambiguous. Okay, so people say today we live in a VUCA world, which is changing every day that way. So every moment there's something happening differently. Somebody's finding out something, some new discovery is happening, some invention is happening. Okay, so I think it is very, very important that in this VUCA world, they say jobs will become hybrid jobs. Okay, this word hybrid, like your learning is going to become hybrid. Okay, there was a time when you will only go to a college and learn. That was only face to face. Today, that's not so. Today, you're learning through media, through technology media, okay, online. Okay, so all this. So there is going to be both the kinds of learning, a face to face learning, and you will have this kind of learning. So that's what they're going to call it, phygital. Okay, it's a physical and digital world, it's going to be. Okay, so it's a hybrid learning. Same way, jobs are also going to be hybrid jobs. Okay, so very important that you have knowledge, you need to have skills, you'll need to have technology. Okay, and when you have skills, you'll need to have important skills like critical thinking, creativity, agility. Okay, so that you can multitask. Okay, so easily multiple things you will be able to handle. Okay, at particular moment, even if you handle one thing, you need to have the ability to move and handle something else. Okay, so that's how hybrid jobs, or super jobs, people are going to call it that way. Okay, so I think, yeah, there may be a time when you will go half a day to one company, do something there, and maybe like the next half a day, you can go to another company and do something there. Okay, so it's going to be completely different. And that's easily possible with technology today. Okay, so you go to a place, you finish your job, and you document everything. So the next person who comes will look at the computer, see what all you have done, and will start from there. That way. So you don't have to really explain it to them. Today, everything is on a platform. Okay, so people are saying from farm and factory, life has moved to the cloud now. Okay, so everything is on the cloud. You ask anybody, they say it's on the cloud. Okay, and from offices, we are going to move to digital spaces. So that's how life is going to be completely different, whether it's even agriculture, whether it's healthcare, people are going to sit at home and talk to a doctor. You can have telemedicine that way, unless there is a surgery, only then you'll need to go to a hospital. Otherwise, sitting at home, you will get all the advice. You can just then, look at this prescription, just upload it to a pharmacy. The pharmacy will come and deliver you the medicine. That's it over. You don't even have to do anything. Okay, so many things I think will change. The way we are living, you can, as you're coming in your car, you can just put on your AC, you can put on your geyser. Okay, so that when you just enter the house, you will have the hot water ready. Okay, the AC will be there ready, the house will be cool. Everything can happen. People are talking about driverless cars. Can you imagine? 10 years back, did you ever imagine that we will have driverless cars? Okay, so today it is there that way. Okay, so I think that is how life is completely changing. So what we need to do is unlearn. Okay, many a times, there are many things which we have learned all these years. Okay, time for us to unlearn the redundant things. Okay, whatever is old, you need to remember, but you need to keep it aside and start learning the relevant things. What is relevant, you need to keep for yourself. Okay, so unlearn, keep the redundant things out, learn and keep the relevant things in. Okay, so it's important at this point in time that we really keep learning. I think learning is something which you can do till the last breath. I always say this to everybody. Okay, you may have everything in life. You may have a house, a car, or so much of, money and all that. Everything can go away from you. Okay, but what you have learned is yours. Nobody can take away what you have learned and experienced. Okay, so learning is, like they say, change is the only constant. Learning is something that will never be taken away from you. Okay, so I think just keep that in mind. Keep learning, keep adding value to yourself. There is so much to really keep learning about that way. Okay, and don't get scared about any challenges. I think have that confidence. Okay, so that's why I want to end with this last slide, which is a bird which is very close to my heart, the eagle. Okay, people, you know that well. Eagle is one bird which really flies high. And they normally say whenever there's a storm, most of the birds will fly fast to go and sit in their own place or in their own nest or in their own trees and branches. But the eagle, apparently what it will do, it will fly high and use the speed of the wind to race high and be above the storm. That is why it says, when a storm is coming, all of the birds seek shelter. The eagle alone avoids the storm by flying above it. So in the storms of life, may your heart soar like an eagle. Okay, so you can also fly like an eagle that way. Manage the storm. It doesn't matter. Storms will keep coming in our life. Okay, so we don't have control over it. Okay, there will be something. Challenges. People will keep throwing challenges at you. Life will keep throwing challenges at you. Okay, but you need to raise above that. Okay, you need to really soar like an eagle that way with that focus. Eagle also, as you know, is one bird which has tremendous focus. Even if it's flying high, if there is a small worm down, it will be able to spot that worm. Okay, so be like an eagle, soar high, but have that focus. And there's so much to learn for you. I think go out and learn, add value, and you will be definitely be successful and happy, because these both the things are important. It's, I mean, not all successful people are happy. Okay, so ultimately it's happiness that really matters, but be successful and happy. Okay, so that's what life is all about. So keep soaring high, do well. I'm sure there's so much. So I think COVID or whatever it is, nothing should shake you. Okay, it's okay. It's a temporary phenomena. This too shall pass. It will pass one day that way. Okay, so we need to come out of it. Utilize this opportunity. Do something, some solid, so that like there were memes going when, you know, 10th standard, when they announced that, you know, no exams, people saying Corona batch. Like that, say, during Corona, I learned this. Okay, because of Corona, I learned this. Okay, say that. And I think you should be able to do that. Okay, learn something, join something, learn something new. And I'm sure it will be useful all through your life. All the very best.
Thank you so much, ma'am. So thank you very much for the invaluable inputs, ma'am. It's our pleasure to honor to have addressed this gathering. So Thiruvalluvar says, Sarkariya Saivar Periyar. Same, you are a mean for that actually. This has created a lasting impact on the minds of all the youngsters who have attended this session. I wait the day when the Mafai Group of Company becomes your Fortune 500 firm. Thank you again, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, Alil. Thank you, everybody. All the best to all the participants. I think, as you said, keep learning and keep flying high. But don't lose focus and passion. All the very best.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am. So thank you so much, guys. If you have any kind of doubts, any kind of clarification, just subscribe our channel, AJIT Technical Campus. Send a mail to us, trg@ajitrg.com. And if you have any doubts, call me 9841-81842. And AJIT Technical Campus or AJIT Industrial Campus in Facebook page is there, just like this. Thank you for all this great successful event. And next program is the next Saturday, 5 o'clock, the same time. We have with one other industrial people, with industrial experts, we will come and meet again. Thank you so much.
The video, subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon for latest video updates.